Konstantinos Evstathios, welcome to the Media Box. Your report is about implementation of Court of Human Rights judgments. There seem to be a number of countries that just aren't applying the judgments quickly enough or indeed at all. What is going on?
I think comes out from the report is that most of the times the countries where for political or internal reasons they are reluctant to go into the implementation of the judgments, and unfortunately these countries still remain the same number, about 10, with some thousands of non-implemented judgments. And this is has nothing to do with that they are not eager or they are not capable of doing so. It's that they pretend sometimes, or they take advantage of some structural problems they used to have. They don't change it. They live with it. And of course, they fear that by implementing a judgment, that can harm their internal order, which is something which is incompatible with the freedom, the space of freedom and democracy where Council of Europe represents. So there is a contradiction between the membership of Council of Europe and the obligation of respecting the rule of law. Because without implementing the judgments, there is no rule of law. Rule of law is based on the respect of the judgments of the law and to implementation of both.
In fact, that's really what the Council of Europe is all about, isn't it? It is built around the law about the European Court of Human Rights. And if it says in your report, there are something like 5,000 judgments that have not been applied. I mean, no one will be surprised by the countries that are mainly responsible: the Russian Federation, Turkey, Ukraine, Romania, Hungary, Italy, Greece, the Republic of Moldova, Azerbaijan, and Bulgaria. Well, no one's going to sit down and say, well, that's a surprise. But what can be done about it? How can you encourage them?
Yeah, there is a special procedure which has been firstly used against Azerbaijan regarding Mamatov's cave, which had to do with arbitrary detention of a civil action leader. And his incarceration was due to non-judicial interests, but on political motivation. And this procedure, which is Article 46, alinea 4, can give the ministers of Committee of Ministers the capability of imposing restrictions or taking measures against the state. And I think that it is a nice and very useful tool to have the countries complying with that, because the experience has proved that there are some countries who are still reluctant, and only with the possibility of being punished or taking some action against them can only proceed to implement the judgments and comply with their obligations. Message coming from the report, plus that it's time for the Committee of Ministers and all of us to finish with a timid reaction when a country cannot or does not want to implement the judgments or comply with their responsibilities and obligations.
Your report also mentions that it condemns statements made by some government authorities against the court's authority, complaining that the Court of Human Rights has no right to pass the judgments it's passed. I mean, that clearly is not acceptable, but persuading a government to accept that is difficult, isn't it?
Of course, because it comes with the matters of sovereignty and respect of a country's stand in the international community. But since the member states of the Council of Europe have agreed to proceed to a voluntarily diminishing their sovereignty in order to achieve a European space of rule of law, then they cannot raise the matter of sovereignty when it comes to meet their obligations. I think this is a contradictory and is not acceptable in a rule of law, because we still insist freedom cannot be separated by rule of law, and the rule of law always stands with freedom and democracy. So these three elements must be kept with utmost careful actions. That's why we insist, and I think that we, in this last report, we contribute a little bit differently, because we use a more strong language against the phenomenon of non-implementing the judgments, because this is the hard core of the whole system. When it's harmed, then the whole system is collapsing.
It does mean, though, that the Committee of Ministers and the Assembly have to work together. And there have been cases where they have been split on applications of court judgments. Is there a way of encouraging them to work together? We've got a new Secretary General now, after all. Is there a way of encouraging them to work together more forcefully to get the court judgments applied?
It's a very serious question, very difficult to be answered, because, the Committee of Ministers always is representing the executive, while the Court of Justice represent the judiciary and sometimes the parliamentary aspect. So if we don't find a way of collaborating and associating the three powers, then we will face serious problems in the future. That's the message, is that let us doing business more seriously, and no matter there is sometimes it's time to point the finger to the one who does not want or pretends that he can't do and meet his obligation. So it's a matter of attitude and of priorities. And I think this association, this cooperation must be our first priority the next few years.
In pointing that finger, it's going to have to be a jolly strong finger, isn't it?
Yes, of course.
Konstantinos Evstathios, thank you very much indeed for joining me.
Thank you very much for your patience, because you tried a lot of time. Sorry about the inconvenience. I'm very pleased of having this nice discussion with you.